Thank you. very great pleasure to welcome you all to this Abbey Church today for the wedding of Danica and Sam. My name is Alan Winton and I am the Bishop of Thetford, one of the two assistant bishops in this diocese, and I live just along the road, so it's my pleasure and delight to officiate at this wedding today. We are here today to celebrate before God, as family and friends, the love that Danica and Sam have for each other, to witness the vows that they will make, to support them and to pray with them for God's gracious blessing upon them as they begin their married life today. And so as we stand, let us bow our heads in prayer. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God of love, we thank you for the gift of marriage and for the joy it brings. Bless us as we share in this service. We thank you for the love that has brought Danica and Sam to each other. Continue, we pray, to pour out your love upon them, that they may grow together in your sight, and each be to the other a source of lifelong blessing, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We turn to the order of service as we sing together our opening hymn, Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
We have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Danica and Sam, to ask God's blessing on them and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love, throughout their lives, they shall be united as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness, they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union, may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will, to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is a way of life created and hallowed by God that Danica and Sam are now to begin. They will each give their consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. And in token of this, they will give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Danica and Sam, the vows you are about to make are to be made in the presence of God, who is the judge of all, and who knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you are to declare it now. So, Sam, will you take Danica to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Danica, will you take Sam to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? One of the lovely features of the contemporary wedding service is that the congregation also have an opportunity to express their consent and their support for this marriage. So in response to my question, I'd like you all to say with appropriate enthusiasm, we will. So will you, the families and friends of Danica and Sam, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Let us, as we stand here, let us pray. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Danica and Sam, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. I think I'm just going to sit down for a moment. Don't sit down, so. going to listen to our readings now.
Love is friendship caught fire. It is quiet, mutual confidence, sharing and forgiving. It is loyalty through good and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is content with the present, hopes for the future, and does not brood over the past. It is in the day in and the day out chronicles of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working towards common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for the great many things you lack. If you do not have it, no matter where else there is, it is not enough.
You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making commitments in an informal way. All of those conversations that were held in a car, or over a meal, or during long walks, all those conversations that began with when we're married and continued with I will, and you will, and we will. All those late night talks that included someday, and somehow, and maybe. And all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things, and more, are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we promised, and hoped, and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another, and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you have learned much from one another these past few years. Shortly you shall say a few words that will take you across the threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
Sam, you've chosen some wonderful readings for us today, and some excellent people to read them for us. Readings for us to ponder on your wedding day. So I won't try and add too many more words, although preachers always say that, don't they? Each of those readings helped to create a compelling picture of the nature of the love you're pledging to one another on this your wedding day as you make your marriage vows. And in your decision to be married, you've also chosen something for which all of us here want to thank you. You've given us a moment of joy and celebration in the midst of what is a difficult time for so many people on the world stage and indeed within our own country. So thank you for choosing to be married, and thank you for giving us happiness and joy as we celebrate with you today. It's wonderful to think for a moment of the thousands and thousands of couples down through the generations who have made their marriage vows at this chancel step here at Windham Abbey. As they could tell many fascinating stories of lives shared together, so your own journey, your own story of married life starts today. And it adds something to the history of this wonderful place of worship. And it is also a cause for rejoicing that you have chosen to be married in this ancient place of prayer, seeking God's blessing, asking for God's inspiration and God's strength to live up to all that you're called to be and to do for each other in marriage. I've had the privilege of marrying many couples over the years, and one of the ways I found it helpful to think of a marriage is of something that passes through different seasons, like the pattern of the year. You are in the springtime of your love for each other today. The birds are singing, I'm sure. It's an intense time of newness and new possibility when love is fresh and exciting. Enjoy this season. There will also be summer times of joyfulness, of colour and celebration and sunshine, all the fun and the razzmatazz and the good things that you have to look forward to together. There'll be the mature and mellow fruitfulness and loveliness of autumn, but it's also a season of change, and change will be something you need to embrace together in your married life. And there'll be the distinctive and sometimes stark beauty of winter, alongside those days that can also be hard and dark and challenging, when you will need to draw strength from each other. Through all of this, as you live through these different seasons together, growing and changing together, sharing your lives and your experiences together, you have the chance for your love for each other to grow deeper and richer and stronger. And something you might like to do from time to time is to think back to your wedding day. Remember the people who've shared it with you. You might also like to pull down from the shelf your Bible, possibly in your case to find it via your favourite search engine on the computer, and read together that wonderful passage we heard from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. But as you read it, instead of saying the word love that runs through it, maybe try inserting your own name and talk to each other about how you're finding it, living up to this wonderful vision, this wonderful calling of growing together in love. Danica is patient, Danica is kind. Sam is not envious, boastful, arrogant, or rude. Danica doesn't insist on her own way, she's not irritable or resentful. Sam doesn't rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth, and so on. Make it your prayer and your commitment to seek to inhabit and live out that reading, so that the love you feel today may indeed grow deeper and richer and stronger in the years ahead, and in all that lies ahead, in the opportunities and the challenges you'll face, in the joys and the sorrows you'll experience, the highs and the lows that you'll share. May God bless you richly. And through you both, may God bring blessing to all the people with whom you share your lives. Amen. Could I ask you two to come back, please? So I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and of his people. I, Samuel James, take you, Danica Jade, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part. According to God's holy law, in the presence of God I make this vow. I, Danica Jade, take you, Samuel James. To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law, in the presence of God, I make this vow. Have the rings, please. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Danica and Sam a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Danica, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Sam, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God.